Welcome to Colorist Factory. In this video, we're going to understand how to achieve film-like color composition in your digital footage using FilmForever Power Grades. What are FilmForever Power Grades? FilmForever Power Grades are a set of film emulation power grades that are created after deeply studying the Kodak 2383 LUT included in DaVinci Resolve. If you want to learn how a film LUT came to be repurposed as a creative choice by the post-production industry, we've linked a video essay in the description below. Upon its launch, we received a ton of downloads, and a lot of you asked how to properly utilize FilmForever Grades. So we decided to create a series of tutorials on FilmForever Grades and how to creatively use the power of film emulation. If you want to skip to the tutorial, you can skip to this time. However, we strongly recommend that you read through this section to get a better understanding of the core idea behind FilmForever Grades. We've made the product keeping in mind a wide variety of users, including colorists, production houses, solo filmmakers, and content creators. FilmForever might seem like a very complex product the moment you unzip the Power Grade project. But there's a very simple way to understand the complexity of FilmForever Grades. To begin with, it's actually not complex, rather it's diverse in its offerings. There are three major color grades and three bonus grades that come within the download. A basic 2383 rebuild using Resolve's tools, a three-strip power grade inspired from Technicolor's three-strip process, replicated within Resolve, a creative 2383 emulation power grade. In all three grades, an image undergoes our proprietary image processing pipeline before 2383 emulation is applied. As a bonus, we've also included a technical 2383 power grade, which is devoid of our processing pipeline and just offers a Resolve rebuild of the base 2383 LUT. A subtractive process power grade and a three-strip version of power grade, which is devoid of 2383 emulation. The best part is that all of these grades are offered for both studio and non-studio versions of Resolve. If you own a studio version, then each grade comes with three versions offering different ways of compositing, halation and film grain. You can select from Colorist Factory's grain and halation, or Resolve's grain and halation, or Colorist Factory's halation and Resolve's grain. If this seems like a behemoth of information, it must be because of the diverse options available with the FilmForever package. And while it will require an entire tutorial series for understanding how to use each power grade professionally, for now, let's begin with a very basic walkthrough of the 2383 emulation offered in the FilmForever bundle. We have our imported footage here in Resolve. Let's import our first FilmForever power grade. We will import the first FilmForever power grade here. Film manual and halation manual. But before we go ahead and apply it to our footage, we have to import a couple of files into DaVinci Resolve. Let's go ahead and navigate through and add these three titles into our project as matte files. For that, right-click on individual files and select Add as Matte. As you can see, all three files are now added as matte in our project. Now let's head over to the color page and apply our power grade. As we apply the grade, we notice that our clip looks flat. Don't worry. It's because we haven't set our color space in gamma. So we will select the CST node and select Input Color Space as BMPCC 4K and select Input Gamma as BMPCC 4K as well. That's because this specific footage is shot on Blackmagic Pocket 4K camera. If you are shooting on another camera, you can set the color space and gamma of that specific camera. As we do that, you see that our footage completely transformed and now looks much closer to a classic film look. But we aren't done here. We'll disable the tone node and then come back to our white balance node. We'll click on the magic wand icon on the top left corner. We'll go ahead and try to quickly balance our shot by trying to make sure that the details on the vectorscope align on the center of the graph axis. Once the white balance is done, you can see that the image looks far better now. But I'd like to adjust the image a bit more before moving ahead. So I'll add the node before white balance node. You can also add it after the white balance node. We'll name it adjustment. Let's add a bit of contrast. We'll play with the pivot control to make sure our skin tone sits under a proper exposure. As a personal preference, I like to shift my skin tones a bit towards pink, and so we'll add a little bit of magenta in the midtones. We can also see that our highlights are a bit blown out here. So we'll quickly fix that by bringing down our log highlights. We'll pull down our high range. We'll quickly further refine our contrast and midtones to fine-tune our image. Finally, we'll go ahead and enable our tone node. It's a part of our power grade that adds a contemporary warm look to your image. While it can be a common preference for a ton of creators and colorists, for this footage I would simply go ahead and reduce the node opacity from 0.5 to 0.250 to my personal liking. Let's zoom in our image here to check out the film grain on our image. If you want, you can go ahead and change the opacity or texture of the film grain. For that, we'll go ahead and right-click on our grain node and click on Show Compound Node. This film grain mat is one of the three files that we imported as mat in our timeline at the beginning of our tutorial. You can also go ahead and apply fine, ultra-fine or coarse film grain that is supplied with the FilmForever package. We'll cover that in another tutorial. For now, we will try decreasing the opacity of our external film mat here. And once it's set to the desired opacity, we can exit the compound node. In case you want to disable the film frame as well, you can right-click on the frame node, click on Show Compound Node, and we will disconnect the mat layer from our layer mixer node. Then we'll exit the compound node. In case you want to remove the film dust layer, we'll do the same with our film dust node. Moving on to our next shot, we'll try applying the rebuild version which uses Resolve's film OFX. We'll import it and apply it on our second shot. Again, we'll change our color space transform to BMPCC4K. The footage looks incredibly oversaturated and unusable. So let's fix our white balance. We'll disable tone node. Fix our white balance. We'll enable our tone node again and reduce the opacity to our liking. Then, we'll add an adjustment node before white balance and tweak contrast and pivot to our liking. I'll add a bit of magenta in midtones. And our grade is almost finished. Now, to tweak the film grain in this one, we'll get inside the compound node and we'll directly modify the grain settings in the film grain OFX node. For this image, I'd like to decrease the grain size, increase its strength and decrease its overall opacity. Once it's done, we can exit the compound node and our look is complete. That's how you apply FilmForever Power Grades in DaVinci Resolve. With more updates, we're going to fine-tune our FilmForever Power Grades even more and make them even more powerful for colorists and filmmakers over time. The beautiful footage we used here is from ArtGrid. If you are looking for beautiful collections of story-based raw footage for your color, editing, music video, or film projects, you should definitely check out ArtGrid. The link in the description is going to give you 2 months extra. This was just a basic walkthrough on FilmForever Power Grades. If you are interested in learning more about FilmForever Grades and color grading techniques, we have more videos and tutorials waiting to be released soon. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon. And follow us on Instagram @ColoristFactory to stay updated. Until next time.